Hello everyone, myself Razal Jain Shamsundar. I am from RBNB College, Sri Rampur. In today's lecture, we see some important concept related with the chapter Mathematical Logic. Okay, this is one of the very important chapter in our syllabus. Let's go with our first definition in this chapter. Okay, here first is statement pattern. Statement pattern, and to define this statement pattern, we consider some simple statements, we consider some logical connectives. Here we denote simple statements by using the lowercase letters, that is here P, Q, R, S, and so on. I repeat, here we denote simple statements by using the lowercase letters. Here we use small p, Q, R, S, and so on. Then we use some logical connectives. We know logical connectives here for conjunction, disjunction, then conditional, biconditional. We denote conjunction by using this notation. Then we denote disjunction by using this notation. Then we denote the conditional by using this notation. And in last, we denote biconditional by using the notation this double implies, double implication. Okay, try to remember, this is for and, this is for the logical connective and, the second is for logical connective or, third is for if then, and this last is for if and only if. Okay, so using these two, using the simple statement and using the logical connectives, we have to define the statement pattern. Let us see some examples. Here in first we consider P implies negation of Q. This is our statement pattern. Why? Since here P and Q, two simple statements are given, we denote these statements by using the lowercase letters. Okay, then we use here connective conditional, that is implication. We use simple statements, we use logical connective, so this is the statement pattern. Then in second, here negation of P implies Q, then double implies here P and Q. This is also the statement pattern. Since in them simple statements are used and some logical connectives are used. Here logical connectives are here implication, here double implication, that is biconditional, next here and, that is conjunction is given. So these two are example for the statement pattern, that is we define statement pattern by using these two example. Okay, then in this chapter our next one very important concept is for logical equivalence. Okay, let's define logical equivalence. Here logical equivalence. Okay, again to define this logical equivalence, we use the statement pattern. Okay, then okay, let us consider two statement patterns. Here A is the first one, B is the second one. Here these two statement patterns are equal if and only if their truth values are identical. I repeat again, here A is the first statement pattern, B is the second statement pattern. These two statement patterns are equal
if and only if your truth values for A and B are identical. ते दोनी ही सार की पाई जे. Okay? So, we define the logical equivalence. Try to remember this concept. We have to see some important examples related with this concept in next session. Okay? So, in next, here we define a tautology, contradiction and contingency. Let's define tautology first.
Tautology
to define the tautology, we consider statement pattern, and in the statement pattern, that is in the last column of the truth value, truth table, if we have the truth value T, remember this, if in the last column all the truth values are T, then we say here tautology is defined. I repeat again, if in the given statement pattern for the truth table, in the last column we have T, then we say here tautology is defined. Then next important definition is for contradiction. Again, to define this contradiction, we use statement pattern. We consider statement pattern. If in the last column of the truth table, if we have the truth value F, all the truth value F, then we say here contradiction is defined. Okay? And in last, we consider contingency. Okay? Here in contingency, in the last column of the truth table, if we have both the truth values T and F, if we have both the truth values T and F, then we say here contingency is defined. That is, here contingency is neither a tautology nor a contradiction. Neither a tautology nor a contradiction. So here T and F, we use both the truth values to define the contingency. So in this lecture, we have to see some important examples related with these three definitions. Okay, let's go with some examples. Here in first, examine whether, each of the following statement pattern is tautology or contradiction or contingency. Okay, so our first example is having here P and Q implies Q or P. Okay, here statement pattern is given. Since here two simple statements are used, P and Q are the simple statements, then here we have some logical connectives. In that, first is conjunction, second is implication, third is disjunction, Okay, now here we have to identify, we have to examine whether this is tautology, contradiction or contingency. And to examine this, we have to consider one table. So here in table, in solution, okay, let's prepare table. Okay, we prepare table like this. Now in that, we consider the simple statements. Okay, here P is the first one. Okay, here consider this bracket first. In that, our first simple statement is P. So for first column we use P. Then in the first bracket, our second simple statement is Q. So in second column we use Q. Next, in first bracket we have P and Q. So for last column we use P and Q. Then consider the second bracket. In that, given Q or P, that is Q disjunction P. So for fourth column here Q or P. Then in last we consider this whole statement pattern, that is P and Q implies Q or P. So we prepare table like this. Now in that, we have to consider the truth values T and F. Okay, here for P and Q we consider all the possibility, that is all the possibility of truth values. So in column, for column P we use T, T, F, F. Then for Q we use here T, F, T, F. Try to remember, for P and Q we use all the possible combinations of truth values. All the possible combinations of truth values. Try to remember this. Okay, let's define P and Q first. For P and Q, we know if both the simple statements are true. Remember, here for P and Q, if both the simple statements having the truth value T, then it is true. And for all the remaining cases, it is false. And for the all the remaining cases, it is false. Then, in the fourth column, for Q or P, we consider this Q first, then this P. Okay? Here in Q or P, if both the simple statements are false, if both the simple statements are false, then it is false. Here, check this. Here, P and Q both are false. So, its disjunction is also false. And for all the remaining cases, it is true. So, here T, T and T. And for this last column, in that we use this third column implies fourth column. I repeat again, here third column implies fourth column. Okay, and to define this, here remember, if our first statement is true, and second statement is false, then its implication is false. And for all the remaining cases, it is true. So here, consider this third and fourth column. Okay, implication is given. So here both the statements are true. So it is true. Here first is false. Second is true. So it is true. Next, here first is false. Second is true. Then it is true. And for last, here both the simple statement, both the statements are false, so it is true. Okay, so in the last column, we have the value t. Okay, so if all the values in the last column is 2t, so it is a tautology. Okay, so here we conclude that therefore all the truth values in last column is t, hence it is tautology. Okay, very simple example. Here we have to remember, if all the values in the last column are true, then it is a tautology. Okay, let us see second example. Okay, here in second we consider P and Q, then and here negation of P or negation of Q. This is also a statement pattern, since in that we use the simple statements, we use some logical connectives. Here connectives are here and or. Okay, we have to examine whether this is a tautology or contradiction or contingency, and to examine this we have to consider one truth table. So in the truth table we consider, okay, here two simple statements are given, P and Q. So in the first column we consider P, for second column we consider Q. Let us consider this first bracket first. Okay, here P and Q is given. So for the third column we use P and Q. Then consider the second bracket. In that, first negation of P is given. So for fourth column we use negation of P. Next, here negation of Q is given. So for next column we use negation of Q. Then we consider this bracket, negation of P or negation of Q, for the next column. Here negation of P or negation of Q. Now we know this P and Q, we know negation of P or negation of Q. Let us consider this statement pattern for the last column. Here P and Q and negation of P or negation of Q. Okay, here we have to consider all the possible truth values for all the possible combination of truth values for P and Q. Okay, here P is having T F F. Okay, Q is having T F T F. Then we define this third column first. Okay, here P and Q is given, and try to remember here for P and Q, if both the simple statement is having truth value T, then it is true. Here check this, here P is true, Q is true, so P and Q is true, and for all the remaining cases it is false. Okay, here both here simple statements, first simple statement is having T, second is having F, so its truth value is F. Here first is having F, second is having T, so its truth value is F. Next, here both the simple statements is having F, so it is F. Okay, then here for fourth column we define negation of P, and to define this we consider first column. Okay, try to remember, if our first statement is true, then its negation is false. If our statement is false, then its negation is true. Try to remember this. Okay, so here for negation of P, we consider this first column. In that, firstly T is given, so its negation of T is F. Here again, second is T given, then its negation is F. Here F is given, so its negation is T. Next, here F is given, so its negation is T. Now, to define this negation of Q, we consider second column. Okay, here negation of T is F. Here negation of F is T. Next, here negation of T is F. Last, here negation of F is T. Okay, now for sixth column, we consider this fourth and fifth column. Fourth column or fifth column. Now for or, if both the simple statement having truth value F, then it is F, and for all the remaining cases it is true. Okay, let's check. Here both is having F, so it is F. So this is having F. Okay, here first is F, that is first is false, second is true, so it is true. If first is T, that is true, second is false, then it is true. In last, both is having truth value T, so it is true. Okay, so by using this fourth and fifth column, we define this sixth column. Okay, now in last, we consider this third column and sixth column. Third column and sixth column. Okay, here and is given, and for and, if both these simple statements is having truth value T, then it is T, that is then it is true, and for all the remaining cases it is false. Let's check. Here first is having T, second is having F, so it is F. Then here first is having F, second is having T, so it is F, that is false. Next, first is having F, second is having T, then it is F. In last, here the first is having F, second is having T, so it is F. Okay, try to remember this. So in the last column, we have the truth values F. All the truth values F. Okay, since here F is given, we say it is a contradiction. Okay, therefore all the truth values, all the truth values in last column, last column is R F. Okay, so we say hence it is a contradiction. It is a contradiction. Okay, very simple example. We consider the statement pattern, we consider the truth table, we check the last column. By using the last column, we conclude that here it is a contradiction. Okay, so these examples are very important in our syllabus. Try to remember these two examples. Okay, let us see some another examples of logical equivalences. Okay, here example, using the truth table, using the truth table, prove the following logical equivalence. Prove the following logical equivalence In the first, we consider
negation of P and Q equivalent to P or Q and negation of P.
Okay, here we have to prove this defines logical equivalence or not. That is, this first statement pattern and the second statement pattern is having the same truth values or not. We have to check this, and to check this we consider this truth table again. Okay, let's prepare the truth table. Okay, here two simple statements P and Q are given. Let us consider this LHS first. In LHS we have negation of P, so we use negation of P for third column. Then we consider negation of P and Q. Here in LHS negation of P and Q is given, so we use this in fourth column. Okay, now we consider this RHS. In the RHS and in the first bracket we have P or Q. Okay, so here P or Q. Next, here negation of P or P or Q and negation of P is given. Okay, so in the last column P or Q and negation of P. Remember, this is our first column, second, third, fourth, fifth and sixth column. Total six columns are given. Okay, now here for negation of P we consider first column. Okay, here T is given. We know negation of T is F. Then here T is given. We know its negation is F. Then here F is given. We know its negation is T. Then here for F again T. Okay, next, here negation of P and Q is given. That is third column and second column. Third column and second column. Okay, if in the end, here if both the simple statements is having truth value T, then it is T. And for all the remaining cases it is false. So here first is F, second is T, so it is F. Okay, next, both is having truth value F, so it is F. Next, here both is having T. Okay, if both is having T, here we have T. Next, here first is T, second is F, so here truth value is F. Next, here P or Q is given. For or, if both these statements is having truth value F, then it is F. Okay, and for all the remaining cases it is true. Let's check here. These two is having T, so it is T. Next, here first is T, second is F, so it is T. In third, first is having F, second is having T, so it is T. And in last, here both is having F. If both is having F, here we have F. So P or Q is F. And for last column, we consider here fifth column and third column. Try to remember this. Here P or Q and negation of P is given, so we consider fifth column and third column. And in the end we know if both is having truth value T, then it is T. And for all the remaining cases it is false. Let's check here. First is having T, second is having F, so it is F. Next, first is having T, second is having F, so it is F. Next, here first is having T, second is having T, so it is T. And last, here first is having F, second is having T, so it is F. So try to remember here third column and sixth column. We have to consider this third and sixth column to define the equivalence. To define the equivalence. Check here in third column, in first F is given, here F is given. In sixth F is given. Here we have F, here we have F. Then here T, here we have T. Here T, here we have F. That is, this third column and this sixth column are identical. Okay, here here fourth column, column fourth and column six, this sixth one, fourth and six are identical. Since these two are identical, we directly say here this fourth and this sixth, fourth and sixth are equivalent. That is, therefore here negation of P and Q is equivalent to here P or Q and negation of P. Okay, since both are equal, we say here logical equivalence is defined. Okay, so in today's lecture we see some important example related with the tautology, contradiction and contingency. Okay, we define these three definition, we define these three, then we see logical equivalence, we see one important example for this logical equivalence. Okay, in next lecture we see another important concept, and is for quantifiers. Okay, we will stop here. Thank you.